Anything in life worth doing is worth overdoing. Moderation's for cowards. I'm a lover, I'm a fighter, I'm a UDT Navy SEAL diver.
Go on. Hi, I'm Ewin, and this is Auto Running Singapore. Just for a moment,
I went along, lost my focus. You already. Okay, anyway, today we've got Ewin right here. I know a lot of you guys have been requesting for Ewin. You guys should know who RoboTeal is.
Oh, yeah.
He's been very active in the triathlon scene, even until now, taking a break from ultras. And today is just for us to talk about what he's been up to and what his plans moving forward in 2017 and 2018. So first off, congratulations, Axel.
Yeah.
Thank you, bro. That's cool. Okay, so one thing that a lot of the people have requested to find out is, how have you struck the balance in terms of being a father, holding a full-time job as a Singaporean, and racing? How has the training been so far?
I think the most important thing is that you must have your passion in sports.
Right.
That really drives you in terms of your goals towards, driving towards your goal.
Yeah.
But you have to strike a balance being a father, I would say a soldier myself, and also an athlete. It's not easy, but with that goal, with that driven by passion type of spirits,
yeah,
you will know how to sort it out somehow.
Right, yeah. Okay. So we just spoke to Abi some time ago.
Okay.
He has also shared about his struggles holding a job in the uniform profession as well.
Yes.
His struggles having to balance training and his family. We do understand the constraints, especially you're still in the force.
Yeah.
So moving forwards, 2017, what have you got planned for racing?
Okay, because past 2 years, it was a little bit more challenge over my appointment in my work.
Yeah.
Okay, I had to really put in a lot of time over there. And I just ended my so-called,
the tour.
The beginning of this year.
Okay.
So looking forward, I'm planning for more races coming up. I just done Taupo, which is the Ironman Taupo, which is
New Zealand.
Yes.
Right. How was
coming up? It wasn't the best result because I would say I just really start kicking in back into all the long distance.
Right.
Looking forward, yes, I have up to maybe planning 2 to 3 more Ironman, and that is looking forward to it. Not sure when are the Ironman races that I'll be doing, but definitely at least another 2 more.
Do you think you'll be coming back to ultras anytime soon this year?
Actually, ultra has always been my
thing, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So for me, it really just trigger. You know, sometime when the race is there, the time is right, I'll go for it. Like for example, MR25 2015, it was one of that, because I know that I have to be in Brunei for 1 month. And that was in January, so I told myself, why not give it a good one on December, just before I fly, and I can take a break in January.
Okay.
And I did pretty well for that.
MR25, right?
Yes, yes. Okay. I came in second place, I think.
See? No excuses, right? You got to get work done. Okay, so I understand a couple of races that you probably have done. You've done the 84 Sundown, the 100.
Yep.
You've done Sunrise to Sunset.
Yes.
Mongolia Ultra.
Yes.
That's the 100K, I believe.
Yes, it's 100K.
And you came in third.
Came in third, yes.
Okay, how was that experience? So, I think for us, it's okay to race in Singapore. We still need the training for sure.
Yep, yep.
But having said that, going overseas, planning for that, how has the training been training for an overseas ultra? How many weeks out do you start planning for that race? Like for instance, it is in 6 months?
Yes.
How early do you start training for that particular race?
Okay, so how do I do it is, for the Mongolia, it was a SCF sponsorship.
Oh, you guys went together?
Yes.
Okay.
So we are kind of like a little bit more privileged in terms of having more time to train. We are kind of like attached out. And
you and Davis are out there?
Yes.
Okay.
Davis,
okay.
Yeah, yeah. So we did, we have some program.
Right.
But all in all, because we still have our job to do. And the most important thing is you need to hit your key workout. For example, you need to hit a 50K continuous run at certain terrain, at certain time. You know, certain juncture, you must do it. And we also plan for a Hong Kong training.
Okay.
We went over to Hong Kong and did the McLeod's Trail. Not all in all, but we bring into stages. Like
a lot
first
of steps.
Yes. So, yeah. So I think it's good because Mongolia is considered an alpine race.
Okay.
It's not flat, it's not a desert race. It's very good for us to go to Hong Kong to get our legs kicking up and down the terrain.
Okay.
I think that's very important. So I think that one really helped us a lot.
We have got crazy amount of events, like even now Monster 200
is
going on.
Yes,
right? people are finishing at 36 hours, amazing time.
Yeah.
So going back into local races, like for instance 100K, what is your head game going on when you toe the line? Do you aim to win? Do you aim to podium? Or do you just want to let it go and just enjoy the race? I don't know, what is your head game going into the Sundown 100, for example?
Okay, Sundown 100.
Yeah.
Okay, Sundown 100, yeah. I was aiming to win.
Okay.
To be in the podium. Okay. Because I know my preparation leading up from 2010, it was very good.
Okay.
I had a very good 84K run.
7 hours plus, I presume?
7 hours plus, yeah, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Then I transit to, I think if I'm not wrong, it was Mongolia after that.
Right.
Then after that, I transit to Sundown. So I know that I have the mileage and the
base. Right?
So going ahead, because I love to run, that's the most important thing. And you will just keep going on. I mean, you definitely have to plan your nutrition and all those. These are all the sub preparation that you need to have.
Right.
But ultimately, the willpower to run long, you need to have it there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So going in, you wanted to win that race.
Yes.
You came in third, right?
Yeah.
What was that one factor that mitigated you to be like, oh man, I wanted to go into second place, first place? What was that one factor that you couldn't change in the Sundown 100?
I think I have no regret because.
Okay.
Really, I mean the first two guys are overseas runner.
Are they Gurkhas?
No. One was a Bruneian soldier.
Okay.
He's a full-time athlete. And we have the first guy was his Morocco.
Oh, the Moroccan, right?
Yes.
I think he's a Muslim runner, I think.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
And
okay.
They are really strong. I have to give it to them.
Okay.
I did my best, push it through. I mean I was really neck to neck with one of the Australian guys.
Yep, we're following.
Yes, all the way until 60K.
Were you drafting him or was
No, no, we are just neck to neck at 4:30 pace.
Oh my god, really?
Yes. And in the end, yeah, and he chose to stop. That's why I was quite happy.
He chose to stop. Okay. Yeah. Okay. I think you pretty much laid everything out there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So going on to the next question. So how has it been being Axel's daddy? Has he been great at home or waking up at crazy times?
I mean it's very tiring. I mean any father will tell you it's not easy.
Not easy.
But it gives you a different purpose in life again.
Okay.
For example, after training, you want to go back, you know. You want to finish your workout fast to see your son there happily playing. I mean, in fact, he's crying. He's cute, you know. I mean, I don't know how to explain
it. You can see his smile.
So really,
how old is he already?
He's 8 months now.
8 months?
Yeah.
So is he in infant care or?
No. So my wife is taking care of him most of the time. Yeah.
Okay.
So I have to thank my wife.
Alexis.
Yeah.
Okay, so a sub question from that.
Yeah.
How is your wife in terms of being a support system, in terms of your racing?
I mean,
I'm pretty sure in your job she's great.
Yeah.
But in terms of racing, because that probably is a secondary priority or a tertiary priority.
Right.
How is that, what is her position, you know, in terms of your racing and training?
I mean, definitely she's been with me to many races. I mean, for one tip, you have to bring your spouse over to some race.
Yeah.
So they will understand how is the race is like Ironman in Ultra. So they can understand the drive, the passion that you are driving towards for. And you know, maybe because Alexis has been seeing me, been putting so much effort, you know, she understands. She really give me the support. Yeah.
I'm sure she does.
Yes,
We've been following you. We can't wait for your comeback.
Yeah.
I think this trails will be lit up with Ewin's names whenever you're ready.
Because I have kind of lost touch with Ultra running for a while.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've been doing Ironman races. So it's not that I don't want to do Ultra.
And he's been placing crazily well in his age group. So.
So I need to see, you know, which are the opportunities for me to slot Ultra racing.
Okay. So this year, what triathlons are you taking part in? Any?
I just did Alpo.
Okay. Which one?
I'm probably going to challenge Roth.
Challenge
of Ironman in
with
Arno is going.
Arno
my
is
coach
going.
My coach is there.
Okay.
Yes, I'll be with my coach over at Roth. Looking for maybe Langkawi Ironman.
That's a full Ironman. Second biggest question we really want to find out is your nutrition.
Yeah.
I think many a times even for myself I struggle a lot with the nutritional intake throughout a race. Like I bonk easily, it could be 50 something K in and I start cramping up, 70 K in I start feeling like crap. What is your nutrition plan going on to, especially sunset, sunrise to sunset, the Mongolia race? What was your nutrition plan?
Okay, for most important thing is that you must understand your body.
Okay.
There's the template out there in the market, say, you know, you have to consume salt at 2 hours and probably in 250 calories, you know, in hours. Right. But really it depends on how you train and how you understand your body when you are training towards your race.
Do you think you would trial your race nutrition plan during training as well?
Yes, I do. I have to do it because one of the key factors for an Ironman race event in Ultra is to try out the nutrition that you are going to use.
Right.
That's very important. For example, you are using, say, a certain brand. You got to use it and see how your body actually reacts to it. You know, that doesn't mean that the calories numbers are the same and it works the same.
Okay.
Two different types of gel will probably give you different effects.
Especially if you have GI issues.
Yes, GI issue is one of them.
And I think a lot of people, including myself, I used to make the mistake that I tested something new during the race.
Okay.
And I think it's doing yourself kind of disservice, but obviously what Ewin has said, try your nutrition during a race, I think that's great. You're speaking from a person that has raced very extensively throughout various disciplines, so that's a good sharing. Thank you very much. Okay, so the next thing that we want to talk about is your gear. Currently, are you wearing shoes that are very high in support, or are you wearing shoes that are very minimalist? What appeals to you most? And we do understand that to each his own, what works for him might not work for you.
Yes.
But it's just sharing.
In Ultra or?
In Ultra, yeah.
In Ultra, I would definitely go for a trail shoe.
Definitely.
I mean, I won't use a normal road shoe to run. Because if you are saying that if you're going to run in MacRitchie, that will do. That's fine.
Yeah.
But if you are going for overseas races like Mongolia or even in Hong Kong, you know that the terrain can be harsh. You need to have a more rugged insole. But, outsole.
Yeah.
Then you need to have I don't know. For me, I prefer a softer insole with a outer, harder upsole.
Okay.
So that will play a balance.
So for example, what kind of shoe is that?
In the past, I was using Salomon, and now I'm using Innovate.
Okay.
I mean, this is one of the brands. I use this to run the 100K.
Right.
MR25.
Oh,
and I love
nice.
It. Terraclaw.
Terraclaw is all amazing, right?
This is very, very good. I mean, it feels like a road shoe, but it works like a
trail
shoe. I think. Yeah, it's really one of the best shoes, right?
I think there's so many brands out there that appeal aesthetically to a lot of people.
Yeah.
But ultimately, I think what he said is great. Try out what works best for you. Salomon has been great. You know, Innovate has been great. But ultimately, go and try out the shoe that you like. Your foot width, your running gait might not appeal to what works for us. So, you know, go and try out your trail shoes before even attempting any race. It doesn't have to be an ultra. Okay? So, Spitfire round. Are you ready?
All right.
So it's going to be double words. I'm going to be saying out. You got 2 seconds to answer.
Okay.
Ewin, are you ready?
Okay.
Bike or run?
Run.
Light or night?
Night.
Trail or road?
Road.
Seafood or red meat?
Seafood.
Nuts or fruits?
Nuts.
Pasta or rice?
Pasta.
Belt or pack?
Belt.
Tomato or potato?
Tomato.
Tomato. Bukit Timah or MacRitchie?
MacRitchie.
And lastly, red or green?
Green.
Green. There you go, guys. Alright, so today's session with Ewin, thank you very much, bro. This interview will be on to our site real soon. Check it out. And if you have any questions, you can find him on Facebook. The link right here. Okay, and he'll be more than willing to answer your questions. Okay, Roberto, thank you very much.
Great, thanks.
Okay. Do your shoot now. Yeah, I wanna burn, break, crash, explode. Every time you look at me, I know. Yeah, I